Hi everyone, welcome back to Cody's Lab. So I wanted to do a video on fireworks, but unfortunately things are incredibly flammable right now, so I thought I'd start with something that's a little less likely to start a forest fire. So these little things, known as bang snap, snappets, or poppers, contain a little bit of high explosive. Now the explosive is supposedly silver fulminate. If so, these stains should actually be primarily silver. So let's put a little bit of nitric acid on here and see if that's true. Okay, looks like it became lighter in color. That means the silver was dissolved. That confirms that it is silver. Now they're only supposed to contain about 80 micrograms of silver fulminate each, so I'm going to need quite a few of them to be able to recover a significant amount of silver. I went to the store and bought 100 boxes of these poppers, and after quite a bit of separating, I now have over 5,000 of them sitting in these bowls. Something I've always wanted to try to do is punch a whole bunch of these poppers. So, how about I shove my fist into about 5,000 of them? This might be rather stupid, but let's see what happens. Not very much. It's not like they chain together or anything. And that contains all the silver. Very nice. Look at this on my knuckles. You can actually see where the silver is on my hand. And it's shiny and metallic. That's cool. Backyard scientists determined that these little things are incapable of igniting even flammable liquids such as gasoline. Let's see what happens when I hit them with my high-powered laser. Well, they really don't even burn that well, do they? I guess that's good to know. But I might have to actually put them in my furnace in order to actually get them to thoroughly combust. Here's the gravel that was in the poppets, along with some ashes because I've burned up all the paper. So let's add in a little bit of distilled water and a little bit of nitric acid to dissolve the silver. Now that the acid's had a little bit of time to work, it's time to pour it off and rinse the gravel. So here's the cleaned gravel, and hopefully all of my silver is over here. I'm actually going to precipitate the silver from solution along with the ashes, because I think that'll make things a little bit easier on me. I'll just furnace all the ashes together. But look at that. White silver chloride's forming. Here's the sludge that settled out of the solution, and now I'm going to dry it out. Now this is dry, I'm going to add in a spoonful of assay flux. This contains litharge, which will collect the silver together into a bead. And now I'm going to add it to this graphite crucible. Now let's pop this in the furnace and melt it all down. Okay, now that it's all melty, let's pull it out of the furnace. Pour it out on this little metal plate. There it is. That should be my silver and lead alloyed together. Now all I gotta do is separate them. To do that, I'm going to put the metal into this little porous dish, which will absorb lead oxide, but it won't absorb lead metal or silver. And I just put this in the furnace to oxidize the lead. Okay, let's see what we got here. Oh dear. Okay. Bit of a problem. I'll fix that. Okay, as you can see, the cupel broke, but I got it out. And there's a nice large bead of silver. Awesome. Okay, so here's the silver bead after I've cleaned it up a little bit. And there's the precision scale. But before you weigh it, let's actually double check to see how much silver I should have expected. So let's assume that I could have extracted 0.00005 grams of silver from each of those little poppers. Multiply that by 50, because there's that many per bag, times 100, that's the number of bags that I bought. That means I should expect a quarter of a gram of silver. Okay, I can already tell you this is probably more than a quarter gram. Let's put it on the scale, getting 1.14 grams. So that's actually more silver than I should be expecting. Unless I did the math wrong. Perhaps the Wikipedia number was a bit off. I mean, Maybe it could be the brand, or maybe they just add a little bit extra in. But anyway, I've got roughly 4 times the silver that I was expecting. Let's see what I can make out of it. Before you ask, no, I don't think it's actually the lead that I added to it, giving it the extra weight. Because after cupelling, the lead content should be reduced down to less than a couple of percent. So there's definitely more silver than I was expecting. Well, at any rate, I'm going to flatten this out and see if I can make a coin out of it. So it's not my best coins, but I've scratched AG 5000 Pops in the front and Cody'sLab in the back. So obviously it'd be really hard to make money with these things. I mean, I got 50 cents of silver out of $50 of them. But if you happen to be someone sweeping up, say, Times Square or something, and you had literally tons of them, it might be worth extracting the silver. Anyway, hope you guys enjoyed. I'll see you next time.